Interior Secretary Benhur Abalos assures the public the police are working hard to resolve the recent attacks against some local officials. Maguindanao del Sur Town Mayor Otto Mantawal was injured in a Pasay City ambush last week. This happened several days after separate attacks that killed Apari Vice Mayor Romel Anameda and left Lanao del Sur Governor Mamintal Ajong Jr. hurt. Abalos says investigators are looking at every angle to determine the motive. He adds the Philippine National Police is considering providing additional security to local officials.
We would have to review, no, yung mga, hindi, kasi kung bibigyan mo lahat ito, baka maubos ang police natin eh. So you would really have to review yung talagang kinakailangan bigyan.
House Speaker Martin Romualdez is expected to meet with PNP and Interior officials today regarding the recent attacks against local officials. They are set to discuss the measures being taken to stop such incidents and what Congress can do to help solve the crimes. Joining us now for their security efforts in the wake of attacks against local officials is a spokesperson of the Philippine National Police, Jean Fajardo. Good morning, Police Colonel Fajardo. Thanks for joining us.
Good morning, Ms. Nikki, and to all your televiewers. Thank you for inviting us.
All right, Colonel, first off, can you give us any updates on the three cases of recent attacks on incumbent local officials? What are the investigations yielding so far?
Yes, Ma'am Nikki. For the Governor Ajong case, we expect that in the middle of the week, we will be filing the necessary criminal charges against the identified suspects. And with respect to the case of Vice Mayor Alameda, we have some promising leads, and we're still trying to locate the last possessor of the Mitsubishi Adventure that was used as a getaway vehicle of the suspect. And in the case of Mayor Otto Mantawal, we are still in the process of enhancing some of the CCTV footage taken during the actual ambush of the mayor.
And we have PNP Chief Azurin saying that regional police chiefs should start conducting a threat assessment on each of these officials to determine whether PNP security was inadequate or sufficient. How will you go about doing this?
That is correct, Ms. Nikki. Our Chief PNP Police General Rodolfo Azurin Jr. has directed our field commanders to their respective police regional directors to start conducting threat assessment and coordinate personally with their local chief executive to assess not only the elected officials but also appointed officials in their respective areas of responsibility so that we could assess their current state and to find out and assess whether the PNP is providing enough or inadequate security measure to protect their respective LCEs. And with respect to that instruction, the PNP will also be assessing whether they are these LCEs and appointed government official is getting active threats, and there are intense political rivalries in their respective areas, and so that we could determine whether there is a need to provide additional security detail, particularly if they are leaving their respective areas of jurisdiction.
And should this be approved, how will this additional security work? For example, when these officials get out of their areas of responsibility, will the local police not secure them anymore?
With regard to that aspect, Ms. Rica, we can provide additional police personnel if in case we can determine their areas of events where they will be coming out of their areas of jurisdiction. We can provide additional personnel in their area where they will be visiting or they will have they will be attending official function related to their work. Our PNP Police Security and Protection Group can provide additional personnel. Aside from that, the local police, where their engagement may will be happening, then can provide the venue and area security.
And Colonel Fajardo, what are local chief executives actually entitled to under the 2019 PNP Memorandum Circular in terms of security?
Yes, based on existing policy, Ms. Rica, the local chief executive are entitled to have at least two security personnel that is coming from the PNP Security Protection Group.
And General Azurin also said that the PNP wanted to achieve zero crime against our elected and appointed officials. So far, has there been an established pattern in the three attacks recently?
As of now, we have not established or see any link with respect to the three cases. But nonetheless, we are beeping our security, particularly the personal security detail of our not only of our elected official but also appointed official because of this recent attack.
Mm-hmm. And are there certain areas you're monitoring or local officials on especially high alert following the incident?
That is correct, Mama. The Lanao del Sur, Maguindanao, and 63 barangays in North Cotabato, the permit to carry firearms also the president has already been suspended, as well as in Nueva Vizcaya. The security there has already been beefed up. They are now on heightened alert level because of this incident.
And what efforts are in place, Colonel, to beef up security in the wake of these ambushes?
There are security border control being implemented. There are random security mm-hmm. check and checkpoints in those areas to make sure that there will be no incidents similar to these cases, Ms. Nikki.
Mm-hmm. And in a statement from his hospital bed in Cagayan de Oro on Thursday, Mayor Adio indicated that those who were responsible for the ambush were people who were hurting from his anti-narcotics campaign. Is there any truth to this based on your findings in the investigation?
This is the direction of the ongoing investigation. In fact, at least three of the identified suspect or persons of interest have already been identified. And there were the primary suspect also with respect to the similar case of ambush wherein five PDEA agents were killed in 2018. And these personalities were indeed involved in illegal drug activities. And they were also the main suspects in the ambush of Governor Adjong.
Mm-hmm. And on another matter that could be connected to the issue at hand, any update on the case of the security guard arrested who was disguised in a PNP uniform in Pasig? What was his motive behind this? There was a case of a security guard who was disguised as a PNP in Pasig who was arrested. Would you happen to have any updates as to this case? What was his motive, maybe?
Yes, Ms. Nika, we will get updates on that case. We're still waiting for the official report of the Pasig City Police Office with respect to that case.
All right. And lastly, on another aspect, let's talk about the 180 high-ranking officials who submitted their courtesy resignations. Have they been screened so far concerning to links, to drug trafficking? Any updates as to this?
The members of the five-man advisory group are again expected to meet this week to continue their assessment and validation. And last week, they had a meeting and understand there are at least 118 PNP personnel that were already vetted. And the five-man advisory group expect that more PNP ranking officers will be vetted this week because they are expected to meet at least two times this week.
All right. On that note, thank you so much for speaking to us this morning, Colonel Jim Pardo. As always, you stay safe.